Hi, my name's Rachele Ellsworth and I'm an SLP and owner of Speech Corner. And today we're going to demonstrate the use of our double dice decks. Each double dice deck comes in a small tin. It contains 54 cards. You're going to get an introduction card, a directions card, a game variations card, and some content cards. How to play this activity is on the back of each of the cards is a shape, and those shapes correspond to the shapes on the double dice. So to play, you would take the cards and you would lay out 9 of them in an arrangement similar to what you see here so that the students can see the back of the cards. Once they're laid out, the students get to play. So they would roll their double dice and then it lands on a shape. They look at that shape and match it to one of the shapes on the card. So here they landed on a rectangle, so they would turn over the rectangle card, and then inside the dice is a number. And here it says 3, so they would answer question number 3. So this one is, this is a clock, 3, where do you find this? And so they might say on a wall, or if there's a specific clock in the room, they might tell you where it is located in that room. Then they would put the card down and the next student would have their turn. What makes this game so motivating is that there's 9 unique shapes and 4 numbers inside. So students enjoy this activity because of the element of surprise. They never know what shape or what number they'll be answering. So there's the motivation component of that. And SLPs enjoy this activity because not only does it target specific goals that the students are working on, but you're only using 9 cards at a time. So in my lesson plans, I would put cards 1 through 9 for the first therapy session. And that'll get you about 20 to 30 minutes of therapy before you start getting too many repeats. And then the next time I see the student, I can use cards 10 through 18. So you're able to use the activity multiple occasions without the students seeing all your cards. So they know the activity, but they don't know the specific targets are changed each time they come in your room. And I just showed you the basic way to play, but in the deck of cards, there's a game variations, which gives you 6 alternative ways to play the activity so that you will never get bored with playing double dice decks. This program works with several different decks. There's over 50 decks right now. So if you do one-on-one therapy, obviously you can just choose the deck that the specific student's working on. However, if you do group therapy, you can give each individual student their own set of 9 cards. So that if a student's working on regular verbs and another student's working on auditory memory and another student's working on plurals, they can all be doing the same activity. We're all rolling the double dice and everybody's looking for the star and answering question number 3, but their own star card and question number 3 is unique to their own IEP goals. And so it really helps you individualize therapy, yet have a cohesive activity that everybody in the group is engaged in. And so that is kind of how you play the double dice decks from Speech Corner. The decks will say add-on deck, which means it only contains the cards and not the double dice. And then the double dice is sold separately. And so go ahead to www.speechcorner.com. and look up some double dice decks and some double dice if this looks motivating for the students you work with. Thank you.